So, good morning student, let's start our next lecture about survival and dispersal of important plant pathogen. So, in the absence of their cultivated host, the pathogen must be find some alternate sources for their survival to maintain the infection chain. So, the term survival here means that to being alive. So, being alive, then choose an alternate host to survive, because when there is the absence of cultivated host, or I can say the main crop, the pathogen choose an alternate host for their survival. So, survival is the first link in the infection chain, or I can say the in the disease cycle. So, the initial infection that occurs from these sources in the crop are called primary infection, and the propagules are called as primary inoculum. So, after the initiation of the disease in the crop plant, the spores or the cells of the pathogens, either it is bacteria, fungi, they act as a secondary inoculums and cause secondary infection. So, the primary infection initiate the disease, and the secondary infection causes the disease or spread the disease in very large amount from one place to another place. So, this is all about the survival process of plant pathogens. So, the diagram shown here in which there is a differentiation of the infection cycle in between two, that is primary infection cycle and secondary infection cycle. So, in primary infection cycle, there is this survival, then production of primary inoculum, then dispersal, infection and colonization, then production of survival structures. Similarly, follow-up taken by for the secondary infection cycle, when there is a colonization, production, dispersal, infection. And when colonization takes place, we can see the visual symptoms of this infection cycle. Then the survival of plant pathogen, how they survive. In case of fungal pathogen, they can survive on infected host as a primary inoculum, saprophytic survival, and dormant organs of plant pathogen as a survival and primary inoculum. So, infected host means that host which is infected due to disease. Saprophytic is that in which the organ is, I can say, dead and decay. So, the fungal pathogen get survive on that also. Then the dormant organs. So, in case of dormant organs, some parts of the fungal pathogens get survival on the primary inoculum, and some I can say some parts of the plants. So, this is all about this. Next is the infected host as a reservoir of primary inoculum, how it is occur. So, there are three types of I can say infected host. So, cultivated host, collateral host and alternate host. In case of cultivated host means it is the main crop host, means if a disease occur in wheat, if we are grow wheat, so different type of diseases occur there. Collateral host is that host I can say which have same family as that of infected host. And alternate host is that host when there is absence of any cultivated host or collateral host, there is a survival of pathogen on alternate hosts. So, I hope these all three things are clear in your mind. So, the example is fruit trees, pathogen on fruit trees, that's Plasmopara. Collateral host act as a yellow rust pathogen in wheat, and in case of alternate host, stem rust, barberries, and Thalicultrum leaf rust. So, this is the types of infected host comes when pathogen have to survive. I hope this is clear to all of you. So, next is the survival of phytopathogenic bacteria. So, the word here phyto means plant, and pathogen, you know what, the disease causing agent. So, the survival of phytopathogenic bacteria. So, bacteria can be survive in seed, they can survive in plant residue, in soil, and they can be come through insects also. So, in case of plant residue is that residue which is the byproduct, I can say. It is the byproduct of any crop, so that come under plant residue. So, the example is Xanthomonas, and in soil there is Erwinia, Clavibacter, Agrobacterium, and with insect there is Escherichia trachyphylla, in seed there is Xanthomonas, Pseudomonas. So, these are the phytopathogenic bacteria which can survive in seed also, in plant also, in soil also, as well and in insects also. These are the some examples I am giving you here. So next is the dispersal and dissemination of plant pathogen, how they can spread, how they can transport. Dispersal and dissemination both are the same terms, it means transportation or spreading. So the definition is the transport of spores or infection body act as an inoculum from one host to another host at various distances, resulting in the spread of the diseases. Another definition is displacement of plant pathogen from its place of production or to the region to a suitable place where it can grow or establish. So they disperse for spreading diseases. They means the pathogens. Okay, don't confuse. The pathogen disperse to cause diseases from one host to another host at various distances. They can travel through wind, they can travel through water, they can travel through insects. So this is the definition of dispersal and dissemination of plant pathogen. And one thing more, they can travel from one place to another for good establishment of a disease. So next is the spore liberation, how they can travel from one place to another. First is squirt gun mechanism, second is rounding off mechanism, third is mechanical momentum, fourth is blowing away and spatch. So in squirt gun mechanism, the ascus spores swell up and burst it and blow into the air. So rounding off means there is a sporophore in the round form and they can inject it into air. Then mechanical momentum is through by raindrop, or I can say via wind. And blowing away is the red uridospore, and spatch is the example is pycnidia. So these all are come under spore liberation or taking off. Taking off means from, it's like a plane, okay, like plane take off. Similarly, the pathogens take off from one place to another. So next is the spore landing deposition. First is sedimentation, impaction, rain deposition. So these are just an I can say the examples how they can transport. So in sedimentation, there is the influence of gravity and they can settle down in a particular place. Then impaction, in which there is a wind flowing. And in rain deposition, there is a deposition of pathogen via rain. So dispersal is of two type, active dispersal and passive dispersal. So in active dispersal, there is no any, I can say, involvement of any external agency for dispersal of plant pathogen or spreading of a plant pathogen. So this is mainly in the soil, in the seed, where we don't need any mechanical or I can say any external agency to disperse these plant pathogen. So by soil, there is Python and Phytophthora form zoospores and can swim with water and get into the soil. Similarly, the actinomycetes, cinquitirium and fusarium can also grow well in the soil. So these are the examples of the active dispersal. Next is the passive dispersal. So this type of dispersal are done by the help of any type of external agency. We need any external agency, either it is animals, insects, humans, nematodes. So via animals, they can transport through vegetative propagation, and the example is the late blight of potato, the bacterial wilt of banana, the Ciga toca disease of banana. So these diseases causes by animals, because the pathogen can travel on these animals because they can eat the vegetative part of that plant, and then this disease can spread from one place to another. Then is insect. In insect, there is a cucurbit wilt, there is Dutch elm disease. So some insects can help into spread these type of diseases, especially the beetles. Similarly, the nematodes causes yellow ear rot of wheat, and the Rathibacter triticae. So next is the dispersal by water and dispersal by wind. So dispersal by water is a surface running water, which causes the dissemination of different plant pathogen after heavy rains and long distance, like floods. They can also causes the plant pathogen dissemination. Some examples are Fusarium, Macrophomina, and Phytophthora, Sclerotium. And dispersal by wind is short distance dissemination. Dispersal by wind is a long distance dissemination, and whereas in by wind there is a short distance dissemination. So it is act by different type of, I can say, the fungi like Alternaria, Helminthosporium, Pyricularia, and sometimes there will be a long distance dissemination when the air blow up to some heights. Thank you. This is all about this lecture.